What's up? It's Second Chance Stables here, and I am giving you a Schleich Tack tutorial, as you could see from my intro. So I hope you have all of the supplies. So basically, a style 2 halter looks like one of these little guys. They just look like a halter, and they have a buckle at the side. And mine have a jump ring at the bottom for a lead rope. This jump ring's kind of screwed up. But yeah, so this is that. Oh, and also, before I get started, this is also on my new baby. This is the Schleich Retired, what are you? I think the Thoroughbred Stallion, I believe. I did repaint him because he did have a little bit of rubs and whatnot, so now he's a blackie. But he came out pretty great. He has like his hooves and everything done. Yeah, it's like 1 in the morning and I'm filming a video because I love you guys, so my voice is gonna sound awful. But his name is Samson. He's named after this horse at my barn that I'm going to be leasing. And his show name is Delilah's Savior, because if you guys know the story of Samson and Delilah, you will know where I got that from. So yeah. So this is what a style 2 halter looks like, and I will be teaching you guys how to make one. So this video was requested. Sorry if I haven't been putting up a lot of videos. I know it's been a long time. I am so stressed out with school, and I play 3 instruments, and I'm doing tennis and horseback riding now. I've added tennis to my already hectic schedule, so I have no time to do anything. But yeah, so... alright, so I hope you got all your stuff. If you guys were wondering about the buckle video, I do have a tutorial on the buckles on my channel somewhere. I will probably put a link down there. I'm also filming this from a new angle. It's propped up on my music stand because I'm really cool. So hopefully this doesn't fall during the middle of filming, because then I would probably cry. So yeah, so let's get started. Hey guys, what's up? It's Second Chance Stables here, and I am giving you a Schleich Tack tutorial, as you could see from my intro. So I hope you have all of the supplies. So basically, a style 2 halter looks like one of these little guys. They just look like a halter, and they have a buckle at the side. And mine have a jump ring at the bottom for a lead rope. This jump ring's kind of screwed up. But yeah, so this is that. Oh, and also, before I get started, this is also on my new baby. This is the Schleich Retired, what are you? I think the Thoroughbred Stallion, I believe. I did repaint him because he did have a little bit of rubs and whatnot, so now he's a blackie. But he came out pretty great. He has like his hooves and everything done. Yeah, it's like 1 in the morning and I'm filming a video because I love you guys, so my voice is gonna sound awful. But his name is Samson. He's named after this horse at my barn that I'm going to be leasing. And his show name is Delilah's Savior, because if you guys know the story of Samson and Delilah, you will know where I got that from. So yeah. So this is what a style 2 halter looks like, and I will be teaching you guys how to make one. So this video was requested. Sorry if I haven't been putting up a lot of videos. I know it's been a long time. I am so stressed out with school, and I play 3 instruments, and I'm doing tennis and horseback riding now. I've added tennis to my already hectic schedule, so I have no time to do anything. But yeah, so... alright, so I hope you got all your stuff. If you guys were wondering about the buckle video, I do have a tutorial on the buckles on my channel somewhere. I will probably put a link down there. I'm also filming this from a new angle. It's propped up on my music stand because I'm really cool. So hopefully this doesn't fall during the middle of filming, because then I would probably cry. So yeah, so let's get started. Okay, so the best thing about getting a... making your own halters is that they will be super realistic, because the Schleich ones are not that realistic. Like, I don't see a lot of those kinds of halters around my barn. Those are probably for like show, I guess, like halter classes and all that. But this halter is just for like everyday stable use. So it is, it does look more realistic, and it's actually quite really easy to make. So the most important thing about these kinds of halters is you want to make sure you measure them properly, like this one, to sort of fit their face. Otherwise it'll like droop off and look kind of weird, and you don't really want that. So first thing you're going to do is grab one of your jump rings. So I'm going to grab one of my jump rings. So I'll hold them up with pliers so you guys can see them. So this is what they look like, aka you have one jump ring. Ta-da! So what you're going to do is you're going to grab your ribbon. So I have my ribbon here, and you are going to thread this through. Actually, yeah, this way would probably be better. And you're going to sort of thread this through like that. And what you're going to do is find the place in the jump ring where it sort of has that little break in it. That break is there for jewelers to be able to open it and add beads and clasps and stuff, but we don't really need that, so I don't like it when that shows. So if you can see here, I found a little break, and I put the ribbon right under it. So what you're going to do now is you're going to take it, get your hot glue gun, don't burn yourself like I did, make sure there's a little bit of ribbon left at the end, just like that. And on that spot, you are going to put your glue, if my glue does cooperate because it's being awful. Is it coming out? You're going to put your glue on. Ta-da! And you're going to fold it over. Just like... Oh, all I can see is my nail. But just like that. So now you have this. So... next step is always to trim, because I hate messy stuff. So you're going to grab your scissors, and if you have any like parts sticking out like I do here, you're just going to grab your scissor and trim them. So yeah, so now you shouldn't be able to see that broken part in your jump ring, and it makes everything look a little bit neater. So this part is now when your horse comes in. So you're going to grab your model. So right now I have Teddy. He's the Dartmoor Pony Stallion, in case you guys don't know. He's wearing like a really weird blanket. This is one of my older blankets. And what you're gonna do is right where their sort of mouth line is, I'd say, like right there, you're gonna place the end of your jump ring. Make sure it is the side that does not show the glue. So this side, the side that you glued, is going to be here. Let me try to get my camera to focus. Struggles of being a YouTuber. Okay, right there. So you don't want that part to show because, you know, you want to hide all the messy stuff and make it look beautiful. So you're going to grab your model and you are going to put it right where their mouth line is and twist it over and find their other side. So mine would be right there. So hold it with your nail. Do not drop it. Do not lose it. Do not do anything. And you're going to cut that out right there. So... yeah, so now you have this part, and what you're going to do is grab your second jump ring and do the same thing as before. So grab your jump ring, thread your ribbon through, leave a little at the end. I would say that is probably the best amount to leave, because you want to make sure that your measurements will still stay relevant. So you're going to grab your glue again. If it'll come out, because my glue does hates me for some reason. I think it's because I have a new glue stick in and I'm still using the glue from the last one. Okay, so yeah, so now you have that. So once again, you're going to trim all the messy stuff because no one wants that anywhere. It's so much harder to try to make tack and film it at the same time, because I have to try to look through the camera to see if you guys can see it, and then I have to look back to see what my hands are doing. So I forget, and then I'm like, what are my hands doing? It's a tough life. Okay. And what I like to do is, if you have any like flyaway bits of ribbon when you cut it, just, you don't even have to stick out any glue. You can just use your hot glue gun and just sort of like rub it alongside the edges where there's frayed ribbon, and it'll just kind of hold everything together, which is the perks of this. So, oh, do I have another one here? What is that? What are you? That was so weird. Okay, so now that you have this thing, it should look like, I'll show you here. It should look like a piece of ribbon which has been threaded through two jump rings. So once again, you are going to grab your ribbon, thread it through, leave a little bit at the end, grab your glue gun. Put a little glue at the end and try to fold it over nicely. That was a pretty good fold over. Okay, so once again, trim any excess stuff sticking out because that is the way we like to live life. And then if you have any flyaways or little frayed edges, just use the tip of your glue gun to sort of bring them to the back. And now you should have this concoction right here. And you're probably wondering, how the heck is this gonna fit on my horse? But don't fear, I don't know. Second Chance Stables is here. That should be my new slogan. So this is, once again, when you grab your model, he's literally like, why are you doing this to me? It's like 1 a.m, I wanna sleep, same. You are going to put it down the way you had it before. Like so, and you are going to, this is such an awkward hand position. Okay, you're going to bring your ribbon around and find where it covers it completely. So where it covers the jump ring completely, and grab your nail right there, take it off, transfer hands, and cut. I just did my nails, so now they're getting all ruined. Huh. How fun. Ta-da! So, now you should have this strange-looking abomination. And you're probably like, what do I do now? Well, don't worry. So instead of getting a new jump ring, you are going... This is a little difficult, so I do recommend that you try to be patient if you don't get it on the first try, because that has happened to me so many times. You're going to thread it through this same jump ring that you did your first one. You're going to hold it in place, so it's going to be kind of bent at an awkward angle. You see that little bit of ribbon sticking out? You are going to take your glue gun once again. My glue gun is not cooperating, so I just literally give up on life. Please, something come out. Okay. And you are going to make sure it completely folds over and try to get it to fit on top. So this is probably where the messiest of my messiness occurs. So what you're gonna do is, once you've glued that successfully, sorry if it's shaking, you're going to grab your pliers or your scissors, and try to just get rid of any excess glue that is sticking out. I think my scissors would probably work best for this situation. Are you gonna come out? And sometimes if you like can't grab them completely off with your scissors, your pliers will usually be able to sort of help you out. I don't really know what happened here. Is this glue or is this ribbon? Oh, that's ribbon. That I don't wanna pull out. Oh, nice. Okay, so if something like that happens, because to me it happens like 50 times a day, you are going to, once again, grab your glue gun and kind of seal all the frayed edges so they don't fray. And now you can stick it back on your pony and see how it fits. This bottom part is so awkward, I don't know why. Okay. Sorry, you guys can't see anything. I'm just trying to make this fit on his head in a nice way. Okay, well then. Sorry guys, there's like dead silence. I'm really lame. Okay, so. Okay, now that it's on your model, like so, you are going to grab Another piece of ribbon, and this time I'm gonna go with green, because hey, green is a pretty swell color. You're gonna grab this, and you're gonna grab one side over here, like so, and you are going to thread it through. We've done this like 4 times now, so you should be experts at this. So like my mantra is to thread, fold, glue, and press. So that's basically what I repeat to myself 80 times while I'm making tack. It's just thread, fold, glue, and then press. So ta-da, now you should have this beautiful thing. So this ear, you're just like, what? Okay. You're gonna stick this back on your horse, like so. And you are going to measure where it meets. So you're gonna see that sort of jawline right there. So with my horse, it's right here. So you are going to, once again, mark it with your thumb, take it off. Oh, don't do that. Transfer and cut. And okay, what's the next step? You guys probably guessed it. Thread another jump ring. So, ta-da. So you're gonna grab your second jump ring, third jump ring actually, guys, I can count. This is why I'm in honors math. I was like, 1, 2, 4, okay. And so it's thread, fold, glue, thank you, and press. Okay, so, and if you have any flyaways, make sure to cut them off. So right now, you should have something of this concoction. So you are going to repeat this exact same step on this side, and I'm just going to fast forward through this part because you guys have already seen it, and I don't want this video to be too cumbersome and boring. So, all right, I'll see you after I finish this little bit. Okay, so, hi guys, we're back. So now what you should have is this beautiful thing going on. You have your little nose band, your bottom part of your nose band, and your two cheek pieces. And this is when your amazing buckle that you made, of course, now comes into play. So this is your buckle. That is what it looks like. You are going to grab some more ribbon. In this case, I'm going back to my blue, so I have a nice little pattern. So what you're gonna do is this buckle has two parts to it. So you're going to thread it through. So you have this thing going on, if you see that. And then you're going to thread it through the second part as well. Okay, I'm gonna have to take my fingers away and try to get this through. Good. Okay. So now it should look like this. So once again, following the same rule with jump rings, since we've already threaded it, now we're gonna fold it over. So fold, glue, and press. Okay, and you don't want to make this bit too long, because then it'll look a bit awkward on the halter. So ta-da, I think I just glued it to my nail. Wow. Skills of a tack maker. Okay, so now you have this, and as our rule of thumb goes, always cut off excess and trim and make neat. A lot of you have asked me like, how do you make like tack that's like really good and like really neat and you know, like how do you not get glue everywhere? And what I say is just practice. Like when I first started making tack, my tack looked like it was interesting. I don't even have any words. It was just very interesting and very gluey. And I was like, okay, so I don't really like the way it looks right now. So I'm gonna try my best to make it better. And even now, I'm not like 100% happy. I feel like, oh, I can probably do more. So what I focus on is trying to improve like I don't ever set my goals to a certain level. I always try to go above them. And then after I do that, I increase my goals even more. So now, after that little speech, you are going to grab, it doesn't really matter which side, but for me, I prefer the right side. So you're gonna grab your buckle, once again, thread it through. And then you are going to fold, glue, and press. I've probably said this so many times that if anyone is ever like, oh, like, how was that video? Or like, what was that video about? You're just gonna be like, well, all she said was thread, fold, glue, and press. So I didn't really learn anything. I'm joking. I hope you guys learned something. Otherwise, like, I'd be really sad. Because that made me sad. Okay, so now you have this. And on the other side, you're going to get a piece of ribbon. So this one doesn't need to be a specified length because you will be able to trim it down. So what I do is I just grab a little chunk. And this is the other side, so this is the left side. Thread, fold, glue, once it comes out, glue. I don't know why my hot glue gun is just being an absolute butt today. It's usually like great on other days. So what you're gonna do now is, you see this top part? You're gonna turn this little like square rectangle-ish shape into a triangle. So just take it and just cut diagonally. That's pretty simple. It can look pretty ugly and ratchet now because we will be trimming it, don't worry. Wow, that was really cool. So you're just going to thread it through your buckle that you so cleverly made and attached to the other side. Just like that. As you can see, my ribbon is fraying, but really I don't care because that's going to be cut off soon. So you can use your pliers to help you. Pliers are literally helpful in everything. So now that you have this, before you put it on your horse to make life easier, you're going to grab your ribbon. You're choosing the side that you did not put the buckle on first. You are going to just fold it down below. So thread it through. So it should be in between the piece that is going through the buckle and the piece, the cheek piece. So you're going to thread it through, fold, and press. Oh, don't forget to glue like me. I was just like, if there's no glue, will it still stay? No, it won't. Okay. Ta-da! All right, so now you've got this attached. Once again, cut off any excess because we don't want it looking shady. Okay, all this fun vocab. Oh, quick funny story. I was in English class the other day and we were reading this thing about a guy named Eric, and he was like, my English teacher was asking us about personal writing, and he was like, what's an example of informal writing? And I raised my hand and I was like, well, if the author chose your own, Eric is bae. And everyone started laughing, and I was like, oh, was I not supposed to say that? So now my English teacher probably thinks I don't know anything about the English language, which is cool. I also threaded this the wrong way, so I will be right back. Okay, so, hi guys, we're back. So now what you should have is this beautiful thing going on. You have your little nose band, your bottom part of your nose band, and your two cheek pieces. And this is when your amazing buckle that you made, of course, now comes into play. So this is your buckle. That is what it looks like. You are going to grab some more ribbon. In this case, I'm going back to my blue, so I have a nice little pattern. So what you're gonna do is, this buckle has two parts to it. So you're going to thread it through. So you have this thing going on, if you see that. And then you're going to thread it through the second part as well. Okay, I'm gonna have to take my fingers away and try to get this through. Good. Okay. So now it should look like this. So once again, following the same rule with jump rings, since we've already threaded it, now we're gonna fold it over. So fold, glue, and press. Okay, and you don't want to make this bit too long, because then it'll look a bit awkward on the halter. So, ta-da! I think I just glued it to my nail. Wow. Skills of a tack maker. Huh. Okay, so now you have this, and as our rule of thumb goes, always cut off excess and trim and make neat. A lot of you have asked me, like, oh, how do you make, like, tack that's, like, really good and, like, really neat and, you know, like, how do you not get glue everywhere? And what I say is just practice. Like, when I first started making tack, my tack looked like it was interesting. I don't even have any words. It was just very interesting and very gluey. And I was like, okay, so I don't really like the way it looks right now, so I'm gonna try my best to make it better. And even now, I'm not like 100% happy. I feel like, oh, I can probably do more. So what I focus on is I focus on trying to improve. Like, I don't ever set my goals to a certain level. I always try to go above them, and then after I do that, I increase my goals even more. So now, after that little speech, you are going to grab, it doesn't really matter which side, but for me, I prefer the right side. So you're going to grab your buckle, once again, thread it through. And then you are going to fold, glue, and press. I've probably said this so many times that if anyone is ever like, oh, like, how was that video? Or like, what was that video about? You're just going to be like, well, all she said was thread, fold, glue, and press. So I didn't really learn anything. I'm joking. I hope you guys learned something. Otherwise, like, I'd be really sad. Because that'd make me sad. Okay, so now you have this. And on the other side, you're going to get a piece of ribbon. So this one doesn't need to be a specified length because you will be able to trim it down. So what I do is I just grab a little chunk. And this is the other side, so this is the left side. Thread, fold, glue, once it comes out, glue. I don't know why my hot glue gun is just being an absolute butt today. It's usually like great on other days. So what you're gonna do now is, you see this top part? You're gonna turn this little like square rectangle-ish shape into a triangle. So just take it and just cut diagonally. That's pretty simple. It can look pretty ugly and ratchet now because we will be trimming it, don't worry. Wow, that was really cool. So you're just going to thread it through your buckle that you so cleverly made and attached to the other side. Just like that. As you can see, my ribbon is fraying, but really I don't care because that's going to be cut off soon. So you can use your pliers to help you. Pliers are literally helpful in everything. So now that you have this, before you put it on your horse to make life easier, you're going to grab your ribbon. You're choosing the side that you did not put the buckle on first. You are going to just fold it down below. So thread it through, so it should be in between the piece that is going through the buckle and the piece, the cheek piece. So you're going to thread it through, fold, and press. Oh, don't forget to glue, like me. I was just like, if there's no glue, will it still stay? No, it won't. Okay, ta-da! Alright, so now you've got this attached. Once again, cut off any excess, because we don't want it looking shady. Okay, all this fun vocab. Oh, quick funny story. I was in English class the other day, and we were reading this thing about a guy named Eric, and he was like, my English teacher was asking us about personal writing, and he was like, oh, what's an example of informal writing? And I raised my hand, and I was like, well, if the author chose your own, Eric is bae. And everyone started laughing, and I was like, oh, was I not supposed to say that? So now my English teacher probably thinks I don't know anything about the English language, which is cool. I also threaded this the wrong way, so I will be right back. Okay, so this is the part when you're going to be adjusting. So just tighten the buckle until it is kind of tight on your horse's head, like so. So you see this long piece? We don't really need this long thing. So you're going to pick a length. So I would suggest about that much, or maybe even that much. And you're just gonna trim there. So you're gonna do it in the same diagonal pattern, but this time you're gonna grab your hot glue gun and you are just gonna run glue alongside the edge so that it does not fray, because fraying is for losers. Also, my glue gun is being an absolute butthole. So just run it. So you see that big blob? You're gonna grab your fingers, squash it out. So now you have this gorgeous looking creation, and grab your scissors and trim it. When it comes to this part, be generous with your glue, because you don't want to be like, oh, I don't want to put a lot of glue on it, and then later when your thing starts to fray, you don't want to be the one crying, because like, yeah. So always trim. So I'm just going to trim this really quickly. You can still hear my voice, hopefully. Okay. Ow, I think I just cut myself. Ow! Alright, so now you are almost done, so I'm so proud of you guys. So, now you have this random like ribbon sticking out. You're probably like, what the heck am I supposed to do with this? Pretty simple. Grab this bit right here, fold it. And then you're gonna find this part. So you're gonna measure it until it completely covers the jump ring. So right there, cut it. You can even cut it a little shorter. Okay, you're gonna take your halter off the model and you're just gonna basically glue it to the other jump ring. So you have this, you're gonna thread it through, thread right there. You're gonna fold, you're gonna glue, and you're going to press. Once again, you can't see anything, sorry, but that was pretty basic enough. So now you have this thing. So ta-da, it's your halter. So this step right now is going to be for, trimming, getting rid of any extra pieces of glue that clutter up your thing. And this is optional, but if you want to add a jump ring, you can. So I'm gonna just grab one really quickly. This is when you actually want to open it up. So you're gonna grab it across the bend, open it slightly. You don't need to open it like massively, that's good enough. You're gonna find the bottom part of your noseband thing. This is not even a noseband, it's just like the bottom part of the front. And you're just gonna close it. So now you can put it back on your horse or your pony or your dog or your person. I wonder if they even make halters for dogs. They probably do make halters for dogs. I'm just being weird. Okay, so ta-da! Now you have your halter. And your horse probably looks gorgeous. And yeah, so this is what it looks like. I hope this tutorial wasn't too long and boring, and hope that you guys know how to make one of these now. You guys can check out my tack shop. It's currently closed at the moment because I have been getting swamped with orders. Thank you so very much. But I will be reopening soon, and you guys can place an order for tack. I'll try to make more videos. I'm so sorry. I'm like, I don't even like my life. Ugh, I love my life. But it's very exciting and very tiring, so I don't really have time to make a lot of tack. But I hope that this video was useful to you guys, and I hope that you liked it. So give it a thumbs up if you did. Like, comment, subscribe. Bye, guys. Love you.